Okay, greetings nga pala. Magandang umaga sa lahat. So ngayon gagawa ko ng tutorial about Laravel. Basic system na yung gagamitin natin na merong CRUD functions. Create, retrieve, update, and delete. Okay, una sa lahat dapat meron ka ng fresh downloaded Laravel through Composer. Tapos save mo na lang sa htdocs. Ito na yun sa akin, nakaraan na yun at nasa Sublime Editor ko na rin. So ang gagawin natin, run natin yung bagong download natin. So ito na yun. So magkagawa tayo ng login at registration form muna bago natin siyang iano, bago natin gagawin yung system natin na basic information system. So una, punta tayo ng resources, view, tapos itong welcome, edit na lang natin to. Ito lang muna, login. So dito sa view, gagawa tayo ng folder na ang pangalan is auth. So gagawa tayo dito ng new php file, login.blade.php. Ito yung login natin. So pangalawa, gagawa tayo ng register.blade.php. Ayan, register. So for this, let's try to delete this default welcome blade. Tapos dun sa controller natin, there in controller, just need either to create our own or use the, what you call this one, default controller. So here are our routes, which is in the web. So this is responsible for everything, right? So basically, first we need to follow the convention of the Laravel, which is MVC. So for this, we need to create a new controller. So that controller will be named off controller. So we're done downloading it. So auth controller will be this. So here in our route, we can delete it if we want, like here in route, and then the default one is to be the slash, and then we can put the name on it, like as is the route name, as will be the route name, like why. Let's put it in the name of index, and then uses the controller. Okay, at main. So here, so we have, if the URL will be the default one, so it was assigned into the route name index and passes through the controller auth controller name and in the function main. So here in our auth controller, just need to create that function main. Here, let's try to have a basic authentication check. So here we need to have use illuminate support facades and auth. So here here. Let's try to check it off. Check. It's false. So we're going to call the auth.login. So what is auth.login? So there in our view, we have a folder auth, and then we have a PHP file login. So if authentication check is false, meaning for that is you are not logged in for this time, so the program will throw you into a login page. And then if you are logged in, so you will be going into, let's say, user that main. So since we don't have this user folder and main PHP file inside user, so let's try to create it for a while. So we have here user, and then main PHP. Okay. So for this, let's copy this file, and this will be server. Welcome, you have logged in successfully. So that will be the thing. So when we try to refresh this, okay, let's wait for a while. Okay, I read the string conversion in web, the PHP line 15. We got an error here in our web. So let me try. Okay, because we're concatenating the route instead of putting a comma on it. So let's refresh it again. I mean, here, since the we don't have authentication and we are not currently logged in, so we'll be given thrown to the login page. So for this, I want to copy some bootstrap. Okay, let's download it, or maybe I'll just need to copy it in some of my files. I'll just download it. Okay, or maybe we can use the CDN as well rather than downloading it. Sorry for that. Okay, let's just copy it. Okay, just to make it more faster, I guess. So here, let me try to create a login form called MD6. Let's make an offset of 3, since the grade is 12, the total grade is 12, so we're making this in the middle. So, and then here, let's try to create panel primary, I guess. And then here, let's put heading of the panel. Basic design that I can give you, because I'm not a front-end developer, but still I can give a good design for that. And here's the body. So here we can write at least excuse me, login form. So let's refresh. So here we have a login form. It's quietly presentable rather than before. So here, let's create form, and then form as a class of the bootstrap platform group. And then here we have label of username, and then input type will be name will be username. The class will be form control. So let's make another again. This will be a form group. Level will be password. And then the input type will be password, obviously. And then this will be password again. So the class will be form control. So I think it's up to you if you want to stick with input type into submit. But for me, I always use a submit, a button, and then change the type into submit. And then putting a class of btn, like primary, and then to the value content text or value log in. Sorry for my cough. So here we got at least a presentable login form. So for this, let's go to our route. This is the route. And since we need to log in our user, so we cannot log in a user without registering a new one. So for that, let me try to put a registration button. Refresh. Let me see the registration button. Okay. I don't know if it looks good, but maybe we can. Okay, wait. We can try to put some design like font color. Here in our route, we create a new route for our registration, like register. Don't worry for that, because while we are coding it, we will be creating our own, what you call this one, our own middleware for checking our own authentication and some rules and everything. Just we are creating everything, the stuff from my tutorial into from scratch. Okay, pagkatapos nito, taglish pala yung ano natin tutorial ko, pasensya na, nadala ako. So let's create register function for in our authentication controller. Tapos tawagin na lang natin si the registration view. Yung registration view natin is nasa view auth post register auth register. Ayan. Okay, let me try it. Copy the route name register, tapos punta tayo sa login, tapos lagay natin tong link dito. Okay, refresh, click register, boom, nandun na tayo sa register. So kunin na natin itong register link. Pinulitan ko yung value ng button natin into submit. So for this, yung kailangan natin, yung basic login form lang ng Lamina, this will be babang tawag dito, username, password, repeat password, email yata. Lagyan natin ng email. Copy paste na lang natin yata ito para mas madali. natin yung email natin. Pasensya na kayo kung hindi ako masyado nakakapagsalita. Tapos, yung name natin is email pa rin. So, tingin nyo, tama na muna itong registration na to, diba? So, yung student, yung first name, last name, at iba pa, ano ba, ilalagay pa ba natin yun? Ito lang muna. Sige, wag lang muna sa ngayon. Yung gagawin natin is i-assume naman natin na magre-register tapos maglalagin. Katapos nito, doon na natin lalagay yung mga information system. Yung information for management. I-manage na yung information na yun. Okay. So, punta tayo sa route natin. Specifically in the web. Magawa tayo ng bagong route. Tapos dito is register underscore check. So dito gawin natin ito na register check. Gawin natin yan comma uses of. Okay, so dito sa auth gagawa naman tayo ng bagong function. Okay, so dito lagay natin si request para mababasa na lahat ng data na nasend natin from our registration form. Okay, so in our registration form kailangan tayo mag-output, maglagay ng CSRF field para ma-send natin yung data in a secure way. CSRF field is blah blah blah. Bakit mali? Kasi hindi natin nilagyan ng parentheses for our parameters. Okay, so for this check natin yung kung meron tayong nakukuhang data like request, return request. So dito sa web kopyahin natin tong route name na registration check natin na dito mapupunta yung mga data na isi-send natin for registration purpose. Okay. So, refresh natin. Click natin. Check natin to. Ayan, meron tayong nag-receive na data. Repeat password, password, at iba pa. So, for this, gagawa tayo ng form validation. Dito yung sa auth controller. So, paano gumawa ng form validation? Madali lang. Hindi ka na mag-import pa ng iba. Ito na lang. This validate all requests with your prospective name of username, email, password, otsuka, epic password, syempre. So dito sa username, required natin siya. Okay, minimum of 2 lang yata, tapos max of 12. So sa email naman is required, syempre number 1 yan, tapos click. Dito naman is required minimum of 6, tapos max of 12. So sa dito kailangan na lang natin itong gawing required, tapos same as password, ganyan lang. So refresh natin, click natin yan, walang nangyayari kasi nga merong error, wala tayong nilagay eh. So para mapa-output natin yung error natin, so mas maganda kung ito yung gagamitin natin, like if error as ano yung name natin, username. So mag-output tayo ng as error, else blank. So refresh natin. Pag pag sinubmit natin to, since walang atayong nilagay, so error to. So yung division na to ma-a-add yung class na has error. So magiging, ang mangyayari dito is magiging red to o pula. O ayan, di ba? So since okay na yun, pwede pa rin tayong maglagay ng yung help block na nakaspan. Pwede yun. Pwede din. Like if errors as username and if suspan natin, meron tayong class na help block. Tapos dito errors, output natin yung first error natin. Itong first is different for collection. Ito yung first data or first row na kukunin ng isang error. Parang ganun. Refresh natin. So, paglagay natin yan, ayan, meron lumabas na pumula. Meron din span na lumabas na username field is required. Para naman malaman niya kung ano yung klaseng error na meron siya or na experience niya. Diba? So, for this, since para mapadali tayo, eh, hindi copy-paste na lang ito. Palitan mo na lang yan dyan ng email. Dito din. Palitan mo lang din yan ng password. Dito rin. Palitan mo na rin yan ng, alam nyo na, repeat password. O yan, lapit na tayong matapos for registration. So, kopyahin na lang natin yan. Lagay natin dyan sa baba. Yung pangalan din. Gawin na lang natin email. Tapos dito rin gawin natin yung password. Tapos dito na rin, well, alam kong alam nyo na to, di ba? So okay, verify natin. Ayan, lumabas lahat. So pag lumagay tayo ng pangalan dito, like user123, tapos yung email natin is hindi valid, tapos yung password natin ito. Tingnan natin yung error na makukuha natin. Yun. Email natin, naka-email type pala. Ayun, violation rule unique. Requires. Ah, okay. At least one parameter. So, here in our controller, itong unique natin is kailangan meron tayong table na users. So, ang problema yun natin, paano natin mapapagana to? Hindi natin yan mapapagana. Bakit? Kasi wala pa tayong table. So for that, gagawa muna tayo ng table. So yung table natin, meron na tayong migration default dito sa ano. So tamang-tama na. Ito na lang yung edit natin. ID, which is yung increment, email, password. O ayun, swak na swak na yun sa ginawa natin. Username, email, password. Okay. So, ang gagawin natin, hindi pa tayo makakapag-migrate. Create tayo ng sariling database natin. So, for that, automation system. Create natin yan. Dito naman tayo sa .env natin. Yung database natin is information. Siyempre, username natin yung default root. Tapos wala tayong password. So, ang mangyayari dito is try natin i-migrate yung nasa database migration natin. Okay, wait lang saglit. Oh, violation of email, user, email, unique, blah, 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 blah. Email send off accessibility. Okay, too long. Ulit kasi mas iba kasi yung mamamigrate tayo na walang error, di ba? register yung default string length natin into 191, kasi yung default nung una is mababa lang. So kailangan natin palakihin. Yung ginawa ko pala yung provider tapos application service provider nasa anong tawag dito. It was there in the Laravel documentation, so you can visit it anytime. So for that, ayun. Okay na, meron na tayong user information system with rules. Tingnan natin yung structure niya. Ito lang, username, email at password. So try nating mag-register, di ba? So for this, we can import the app tapos si user. User model. Si user model is palang. Ito. Ito si user model. So bakit din siya i-import? Kasi dito natin ilalagay yung mga information na gusto mag-register. Here in user, we have username, what to request, username, here in user email, what to request, email, so here in user password, what to yan, this is an Ilocan style. Pag hindi nyo alam yung Ilocan style, gagawa ako ng tutorial about Laravel Ilocan. So, ganito, in-import natin si user model, ginamit natin siya as new object, gumawa tayo ng username as new object for the user class, tapos yung binigay na natin yung specific value na ilalagay natin from the request. So, try natin mag-register. Like admin, password natin is admin at yahoo.com. Tingnan natin. Oh, ayan. Bakit walang error na lumabas? Bakit nga ba? Ah, kaya pala dito. Possibly yung lalabas na error doon is password is not match. So here, subukan kong muna yung error na yun ulit. Tingnan natin, di ba? The repeat password and password must match. So for that, register tayo ng medyo okay na account. I mean, medyo legit. Like yahoo.com, password natin is admin123, password is admin123. So pag na-submit to, ang lalabas lang is just a blank page. O ayan, so for this, na-register na tayo. So, pangit din naman kung naka-register ka lang tapos magiging blank lang yan. So, ang gagawin natin is punta tayo sa auth controller. Gagawa tayo ng back call dito. Redirect. Back. Wait. With args. Variable. So, ano itong args variable? Itong args variable is an array value with an array name. It's an array with an array with an where the first element of the array is name info, and then yung value na is you have an register successfully. Ayun. So here in our registration, paano ba natin ilalagay ito? Dito na lang sa baba, nasa body. Okay. If session has, ano ba yung pangalan na ginawa natin? Info. Info. And if kung meron siya, so ang lalagay sa alert. Success, tapos output natin yung session natin na nakita natin, which is yung get info. So register tayo ulit, delete natin to ulit, here is admin, email will be admin. .com password is admin123, password is admin123. Register natin. Oh, qualified method eliminate routing. Okay, asensya na. Anong mali? Saan yung mali? Eto. Saan ka po? Oh, ayan. 123. Just some typo error. Okay, duplicate entry admin. So, yung ginawa pala natin kanina is na-register na. Tapos, dun na lang siya nag-error dun sa return back. So, for this, back natin again. Lagyan natin ng password na 123. Alam nyo, pag may error, kayong mawala ng pag-asa or matakot. Because in my part, mas maganda kung merong error kaysa walang error tapos walang nangyayari, diba? Submit natin yan. Ayan, you have been registered. Check natin yan dito sa users. Admin. With your email and your password. So, for this, in our registration pala, hindi ko to nalagay. Okay, dito siya sa medyo mataas. Punta tayo sa web, ano yung route name ng login natin, wala, ito lang index, kasi nagsicheck lang siya kung meron authentication at wala, tapos pag meron is pupunta siya dun, yung login natin is ito. So okay, here in our login wala pa tayong mga nilagay na codes, so bulagyan natin yung CSRF. Dito naman is option. Obviously, yung method natin is post. So, here, gagawa tayo for login purpose. Like, route, post, login. So, dito sa host controller, gagawa tayo ng bagong method, which is named login. So, here we need to put the request so that we can receive the request from our login. Login form. So, for this, let's return the request for trial and error or for checking if we really received something. So, here in our web, close muna natin itong register kasi tapos na yun. So, here in our web, we have an action. Tapos, we throw that action into a login for verification. So, refresh, click login. So, here we receive some data which is empty and we are token and everything. So, and then for that, let's try to login our user. So, since we have this and that, well, obviously we need to validate it first. Like, validating is really important. So, for to validate it, let's just say the username and then the password. Okay, it must be required. Minimum of 6. Makita natin yung error so that we can see the error, so let's call the error function just built in in the Laravel, and then the username. So if that will be the case, if if the program will see an error of the username, it will add a class here output or echo a class as error. But if there's no error, so it will also output an empty string. Okay, so we got here, check natin. Oh ayan, it the color of the input box turns to red, right? So put something here, like we have error again of the username. So we have end of the if. We have to put spam here and the help block. You know what? And then we output that error, like error first username. Okay, refresh, log in. Okay, the username. I think we are almost done here. Let's make it quietly fast for a bit. And then here we have password. Controller, which is this, and then the function of main. So here, main. So when the function of main here is called, it checks if you are already authenticated. If not, it will give you a login page here, login page. Then if you are already authenticated, it will show you or it will. Okay, it will throw you into user main, but unfortunately it's not good practice if you call directly the user main here, because user main is possibly in a user controller. So let's create another one. If we have authentication, we have to return, and then redirect and two routes, and then the route name will be user. Is that the password is wrong, so let's try to give him at least invalid combination of username and password. Okay, so refresh. So we have, let me give a wrong information. Okay, I'm sorry for that. Admin is this 5. For that, so username required of 2. Okay, so password will be 6. That's probably correct. Admin. Okay, invalid username combination of username and password. So if you give them the correct information that he needs, like admin, then the password will be the admin 123 login. So, chadang, welcome, you have logged in successfully. So, I think that's okay for now. And then the next time, we're going to design and put some logout authentication. And then the CRUD function will be inside here. Oo, nandito sa loob yung CRUD function natin, like basic information management system. And this will be finished today. Like, today, Friday, Saturday. Okay, thank you for that.